couple tonight on Sydney Soapbox. We're asking, what's a realistic body image? Let us know your views on Facebook, Twitter or email.
In a moment, we'll hear what Michelle Bridges has to say, but first, here's the view from Coogee.
There are a lot of people who are big, but they're very healthy. And there's other people who are quite slim, but they're very unhealthy and they smoke and drink a lot.
I have two daughters and two granddaughters, and I hope that they don't follow the images that you see in the magazines.
If you're clearly overweight and you're eating unhealthy stuff and you maintain an unhealthy lifestyle, then yeah, that's unhealthy.
I think if you're just healthy and happy, then, you know, and you feel good, then that's a good body image.
I think anyone can be healthy as long as you're eating right and exercising.
Depends on the individual, what they eat, I suppose, what they do.
I don't think it's good to be either too thin or too big. But you come in different shapes and sizes. It's genetic, some people. I mean, there's nothing wrong with having curves. It's good having curves. It's sexy. Embrace the curves.
All right, sexy curves. Let's talk to personal trainer, Biggest Loser personal trainer, Michelle Bridges. Thanks very much for joining us. Is the reality of all of this that while we might as a society say we want realistic body images, we're actually just not willing to see them on magazines and on television?
Well, I think given the turn of events over the last few days, you could be quite right with that. I love the fact that Julie Goodwin was on the front cover of a magazine across the country. I think it's fantastic, and I think it sends out a really positive message to all women, young and old. I think we need more of it, more shapes and sizes, different colours, whatever. We need to see more of that in our media, on television, in newspapers and in magazines.
But Michelle, we have seen a lot more of that, especially in the last couple of weeks. Deborah Hutton's come under fire for looking too good. Julie Goodwin for not good enough. Is it time we just gave everyone a break?
I truly believe we do need to give everyone a break. I mean, I think you should be grateful and thankful if you have two arms and two legs and your body's working and functioning for you and you're being the best version of yourself that you can be, no matter what shape or size. Of course, if you have issues around your health and they need to be addressed and that may need to happen through exercise and diet, then so be it. But if you're happy and you're healthy, then I don't think it matters, and I don't think it's for anybody to judge you on that.
Michelle Bridges, thanks very much for talking to us.